Hello student, today we learn about Foster-Seeley discriminator. This one is the circuit diagram of Foster-Seeley discriminator. The output of this circuitry depend on the primary and secondary phase relationship. That's why this circuitry is also called phase discriminator circuitry. Here coupling capacitor C1 C2 short circuited to the intermediate frequency, that is nothing but the input frequency. L3 is AC grounded and input is fed in phase with the voltage across L3. So VL3 is equal to V in. The secondary voltage induced get equally divided across LA and LB. So secondary voltage is defined as VLA plus VLB. Now at the resonance, the secondary current in phase with Vs, it is 180 degree out of phase with VL3. VLA and VLB are 180 degree out of phase with each other and they are 90 degree out of phase with VL3. Now here, see here the circuit diagram again. Because of this, the input to the diode D1 is nothing but the vector sum of VLA plus VL3 and output is VD1. Similarly, the voltage, input voltage across D2 is defined as vector sum of VLB plus VL3 and output is VD2. The output of this diode charges discharges the capacitor C1, C2 and output is defined as VC1 minus VC2 or VD1 minus VD2. Now we are going to consider three cases. Here, see in this circuit diagram, this one is the upper tank circuit and this one is the lower tank circuit. So LACO form one upper tank circuit, LBCO form the another tank, lower tank circuit. Okay, so consider the three cases. In the first case, when input frequency is equal to the carrier frequency, so the reactance, total reactance of the tank circuit is defined as XL2 minus XC2. So XL2 is equal to XC2 at the resonance. So total reactance is zero. So in that case, the input voltage V1 equal to V2. Output of the diode D1 is equal in magnitude with the output of diode D2. C1 and C2 charges to equal same magnitude, but they are in opposite polarity. So that's why the output voltage is 0 volt. This one is the phasor diagram of case 1. Now in case 2, the input frequencies goes beyond the carrier frequency. In that case, the XL2 inductive reactance is greater than the capacitive reactance, so total reactance is positive. Secondary currents lags secondary voltage by angle theta. This angle theta is directly proportional to the frequency deviation. And because of that, V1 is greater than V2. So VD1 greater than VD2, VC1 greater than VC2 and output voltage is positive. This one is the phasor diagram of the case 2. Now see the case 3 where the input frequency goes below the carrier frequency. So inductive reactance is less than the capacitive reactance, so total reactance is negative. Here the secondary current leads secondary voltage by the angle theta. theta is directly proportional to the frequency deviation. In this case, the V1 is less than V2, so out VD1 is less than VD2, C1 discharges and C2 charges, so output voltage is negative. Now here, in this Foster-Seeley discriminator, output is directly proportional to the magnitude and direction of the frequency deviation. But in the same time, it also responds to the amplitude variations in a input frequency. And this is the major drawback of this Foster-Seeley discriminator.